Hello and welcome back to my channel. Once again, this is Teacher Jesse. At sa video na to, ang pag-uusapan natin ay tungkol sa decimal numbers through 10,000 displays. Ito ay ang Math 5 Quarter 2 Module 1. So, Module 1 na to ng second quarter. Okay, so, sa mga hindi pa nakapag-subscribe ng aking channel, huwag kalimutang mag-subscribe and click niyo din ang notification bell para lagi kayong updated sa aking mga i-upload na math tutorial videos na kagaya nito. Simulan na natin. Lesson 1 is giving the place value and the value of a digit of a given decimal number through 10,000 place. Unahin natin ang let us try activity ng inyong module. So, ang gagawin natin ay bibigay natin ang place value tsaka value ng mga digits from left to right. We have 9, 8, 2, 8, 1, 8. Okay, yan. Hindi na sinala ang 0. So, do you have any idea? Kung meron, pwede nyo i-pause ang video and then subukan nyo sagutan. Okay, so, reveal ko na ang answers. So, the first one is tens. Alam na natin itong tens kahit hindi pa tayo, kahit wala pa tayong idea sa decimals. Kasi ito yung place value of whole numbers. Ang value niyan is, of course, 90. Palitan mo lang ng 0 yan. 8 is ones. Ones place. So, ang value niyan is 8. After the decimal point in digit 2, ang value niyan ay place value rather is tenths. So, kung mapapansin nyo, bago nilagay ang S after ng N, nilagyan muna ng TH. Okay, parang ordering ang dating. Ordinal. Yung first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. Yan. So, tenths. Okay? At ang value nan ay palitan mo lang ng 0 tong mga digits dito, tapos lagyan mo ng decimal point, tapos copyin mo yan. So, 0.2. Sa 8 naman, it is hundredths. So, 100, tapos may THS. Tapos, ang value naman yan, palitan mo lang ng 0, itong 2. So, magiging 0.0, tapos 8. Ayan. Kaya, ang 1 naman ay thousandths. Ito. So, 10,000ths, hundredths. Okay, so, ang value naman yan, ganun pa rin, palitan mo ng 0 itong mga digits dito, so magiging 0.001. And finally, itong 8 na to ay 10,000ths. So, it is 0.000 tapos 8. Ayan. So, yun ang place value and value. So, kung titingnan yung mabuti, siguro magkakaroon na kayo ng idea kung ano yung mga place value and value ng decimal numbers. Okay? So, if you got the correct answer, then great job. Proceed tayo sa concepts ng decimal. So, dito, didiscuss ko na sa inyo kung paano ba madaling maintindihan ang place value at saka value ng decimals. Simulan natin with this 10 by 10 table. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Tapos pababa rin is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, the 10 by 10 table has, of course, merong 100 squares yan. Maliit. Okay? And then, kung halimbawa, shade natin tong part na to, and if you're going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 by 5 or 25, dyan na mag-iumpisa ang concept ng decimal numbers. Okay? So, kung i-relate natin to sa fraction, para tong 25 out of 100 squares ang shaded. Okay. Tapos, i-reduce natin sa simplest form, kasi fraction yan, so divide ka lang ng 5, magiging 25 divided by 5 is 5, and 100 divided by 5 is 20. Pwede pang ma-reduce, so divide ka na naman ng GCF, 5, 5 divided by 5 is 1, and then 20 divided by 5 is 4. So, kumbaga, itong shaded na part na to is 1/4. So, kung titingnan mo nga naman, 1/4 nga. Ayan, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So, kung 1/4 yan, ang gagawin natin, di ba, ang ibig sabihin ng fraction ay ang numerator divided by the denominator. 1 out of 4. Or this is the division symbol. So, kung kunwari, gagamitan natin ng division, a long division, so, magiging 1 divided by 4 is 0. 0 times 4 is 0 because we cannot divide. Then, we are going to subtract. 1 minus 0 is 1. Tapos, dadagdagan natin ang decimal point ngayon para makuha natin ang quotient. So, bring down natin yung 0. 10 divided by 4 is 2. 2 times 4 is 8. 10 minus 8 is 2. And then, bring down another 0 kasi hindi pa to 0 tong remainder. So, 20 divided by 4 is equal to 5. And 5 times 4 is equal to 20. And 20 minus 20 is equal to 0. So, the answer is 0.25. Okay, so ito na yung decimal ngayon. Ibig sabihin, itong figure na to is 0.25. Okay? Ngayon, ang gagawin natin ay pag-uusapan nito ng relationship between the decimals and the fraction. So, galing dun sa the same picture or figure, yung kanina, 25 out of 100 parts are shaded, di ba? So, yung 25 over 100, if we are going to read this sa fraction, di ba 25 hundredths ang pagbasa niyan? 25 over 100 or 25 hundredths. So, ibig sabihin, 25 divided by 100 is 0.25. So, kung titingnan natin, 25 hundredths and 0.25, magkaparehas lang ang kanilang value. Okay? Therefore, this figure shows that 0.25 or 25 hundredths are just the same. Okay? So, based on the previous example na pinakita, decimal numbers are expressed as part of the base 10. Kasi kanina nga, 25 divided by 100. And 100 is has a base 10. Okay. Kasi 10 raised to 1 is 10. 10 times 10 or 10 raised to 2 is 100. 10 times 10 times 10 or 10 raised to 3 is 1,000. So, yan ang mga base 10. So, ibig sabihin, the decimals come from the Greek prefix deci, which means 10. Ito rin yung basehan. Kaya decimal, kasi yung deci is Greek prefix yan. At ang ibig sabihin yan is 10. Kaya base 10. Okay. Likewise, kung 3 tenths means any of the following. So, pwedeng ang 3 tenths is 3 out of 10. Pwede rin 30 out of 100. Pwede rin 300 out of 1,000. Itong lahat ng to, itong A, B, C, ang ibig sabihin yan ay 3 tenths kapag sinulat natin in simplest form. Thus, 3 tenths, 30 hundredths, and 300 thousandths, yan, 300 thousandths have equal values. In symbols, we write this as 0.3, etong 3 out of 10, 0.30 or 0.300 or 0.300. Yung tatlong yan ay magkaparehas lang ang kanilang value. Kasi nga, base 10 yan. Therefore, all zeros after the decimal point, yan, mga zeros na yan after the decimal point, when not followed by a non-digit, a non-zero digit, kapag wala nang non-zero digit na nakasunod ng zero, wala na silang, pwede na natin tanggalin or they have no values. Yan ang sa decimals. Okay? So, pag-aralan naman natin ngayon ang place value system of decimals. So, let's have the example number 1. What is the place value of each digit of this decimal number? Yan. Ginamit ko na lang yung mga numbers na 1 to 9, na digits 1 to 9 para madaling ma-recognize. So, ito, of course, this is the ones place. After the decimal point, ang pinakauna ay ang tenths place. Ayan. Followed by the hundredths, thousandths, and then 10,000ths, 100,000ths. Kung continue mo lang yan, millions, 10 millions, 100 millions, billions, hanggang 10 billions, 100 billions, trillions. Okay, kung papansin ninyo, halos magkaparehas lang sila sa whole number system. Kaya lang, wala tayong ones. Diretso tayo sa tens. Okay? So, kumbaga diba, meron tayong tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, hundred thousands, millions. Dito, walang ones. Diretso na sa tens. Yan. So, madali lang i-memorize. Lagyan mo lang THS. Subukan natin ang let us practice ng inyong module. Form a number where 4 is in the tens place. Okay? 5 daw is in the ones place. 7 is in the tens place. 9 is in the hundreds place. 1 is in the thousands place. And 9 is in the 10,000s place. Kung papansin ninyo, magkasunod lang lahat ng yan. Left to right, kaya madali lang. So una, gagawa muna tayo ng ganito. Mga box or lines, pwede. Mga blank. And then, i-identify natin ang decimal point. Kunwari, dito ang decimal point. Kasi tens kasi tayo, so kailangan natin ng dalawang decimal places dito sa whole number. So, sulat mo lang to, 4. Kasi ones na yan. Ito yung ones. Tens, so dito na yan. Hundreds, dito. Thousands, 1. And then, 10,000, ayan. Dito, pwede nagdagan mo ng 0 or wala na. Okay? In other words, the answer is 45.7919. Ayan, ang kanyang sagot. Okay, so ang gagawin naman natin ngayon sa lesson 2 is reading and writing decimals. So kanina, place value and value. Ngayon, ang pagbasa. For example, eto, i-match daw natin ang column A sa column B. So if you have any idea, paano ito sagutin, by the way, ayan, may clue na naman tayo. Napakadali lang kasi meron mga whole number kasi 7 and. So obviously, eto na talaga yung sagot. Okay? So, tingnan na rin, 2 and. Hanapin natin ang 2 and. Kasi ang pagbasa kasi ng decimal point is and. So, letter D na kagad yan. 1 and. Ayan, 1. Wala nang iba. Letter E. 7. Hanapin mo lang 7. Ayan, letter A. Okay, 0. So, walang and. Diretso na. 25. Ayan, 25 hundreds. Kasi 25 kasi yan. And 4 and. Isa na lang, letter C. Napakadali lang. E paano kung wala tayong clue kagaya nito? Okay, so ano yung gagawin natin? So, pag-aralan natin ngayon kung paano magbasa. Let's have the example number 2 is paano ba magsulat ng decimals in words? Okay? Note, we read decimal numbers as we write them in words. Okay? Anong ibig sabihin yan? Like for example, this one. 0.632. So, ang pagbasa niyan, babasahin muna natin tong 632. Ayan, 632. Ayan, yung whole itong whole number na nabuo ng mga numbers na to, ng mga digits na to. Tapos, lalagyan mo lang ng place value ng pinaka last digit, rightmost. Ayan, so 1, 2, 3. Ayan, kadulo. So, tens, hundreds, thousands. So, dadagdagan mo lang ng thousands na word. 632 thousands. Yan ang example number 1. Another, kung wala ganito, mayroong whole number. So, sulat mo muna ang whole number, 153. Ayan. Tapos, ang decimal point, lagyan mo ng and. Tapos, sulat mo naman ang number na nabuo nito. Kapag combine natin yung 0008, yeah, that's 8. So, sulat mo lang ang 8. Tapos, identify mo ang place value. Tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000. So, dugtong mo ang 10,000. Therefore, this is 153 and 8. Ayan, 8, 10,000. Okay, ang number 3 naman is 6 and, ayan, 6 and, tapos 50 hundredths. Okay, so 50, bakit hundreds? Kasi tens, hundreds. Or, pwede rin basahin mo as 6 and 5 tenths. Bakit 5 tenths? Kagaya nang na-discuss ko kanina, yung 0 dyan sa dulo, pwede mo nang tanggalin yan. Kasi ang 5 tenths ay magkaparehas lang ng value sa 50 hundredths. Okay? So, isa yan sa mga dapat nating tandaan. Okay. Common mistakes na dapat mong iwasan. Of course, ang misspelled words. Kasi writing in words kasi tayo. 90, hindi ganito. 90. Ang 40 rin, madalas nagkakamali. Nilalagyan ng U. Pero dapat walang U yan. Another common mistake is the improper use of hyphen. So, pag 83, lalagyan mo ng hyphen. Okay? Pag 300 naman, huwag mong lagyan ng hyphen. Yan. Number 3 common mistake is improper use of comma. Pag ganito, may comma yan. 9,005. 9,005. Yan. Hindi 9,005 diretso. Okay. Lesson, I guess, grade 3 lesson ito or grade 4, if I'm not mistaken. Kasi sa grade 4, merong ganito rin. 275. So, merong, hindi pwedeng lagyan ng comma kasi improper use of comma. Kasi ang iba, 200 tapos 75. Hindi pwede yan. Okay? So, another is forgetting to use the THS format in decimal places. Kagaya nito, imbis na 500, ginagawang 500 or 500s, which is wrong. Dapat THS. So, 500s talaga yan. Okay, yan ang mga common mistakes. Take note. Okay, next is, it's your turn. Tingnan natin. Basahin nyo ang mga decimals na to. You can pause the video if you need more time. Or, hindi pala, isulat nyo pala in words. Sorry. Okay, subukan natin. Start with this one. 0.031. Go. Okay, we'll now reveal the answer. Pwede nyo pause ang video. So, it is 31. Kasi 31 yung nabuo niyan. Tapos, tens, hundreds, thousands, thousands. So, 31 thousands. Okay, I hope that you got the correct answer. Next. Ito, 31.0008. Go! Okay, the correct answer is 31 and 8 tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000. Ayan. Next is reading and writing decimals pa rin, pero this time, paano naman kung baligtad? Ang isulat naman natin ay ang numbers or ang figures. Okay, paano ba yan? Take note, we read decimal numbers as we write them in words. Okay, anong ibig sabihin yan? Yan, 5 and 32 thousands. So, ang una, sulat natin yung 5 and sulat natin dito. And then, 32 thousands. So, thousands, ibig sabihin yan ang place value ng pinaka-right, rightmost digit. So, ito yung concern natin, 32. Paano ba magsulat ng 32? Identify muna natin ang thousands. Tens, hundreds, thousands. Ayan. Kasi sulat mo tong 32 dito. Kaya lang 3 yan. So, kapag nag-start ka dito, hindi pwede. Dapat ang dulo, yung 32, yung 2, dapat nandito sa pinakadulo. Kaya sulat natin ng 32. Ayan. Tapos nagyan mo natin ng 0 dito. So, ganito ang 5 and 32 thousands. Another, 190 and 2600 thousands. So, una, sulat natin ng 190. Tapos, dagdagan natin ng decimal point kasi end. Tapos, 100,000. So, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, 100,000. Tapos, lagay natin ang 26. Ayan, 26. And mga zeros na yan. Ganyan, magsulat ng decimal numbers. Okay, so balikan natin. Yan na. So, ganun lang naman. Please, tsaga lang muna tayo. Maglagay muna tayo ng mga blank or underline. Pag nasanay na tayo, nasa isip na natin, ganito, ilang place, decimal place. Places yan. About thousands at three decimal places yan. Pag nasanay na tayo. Okay, so it's your turn. Sulat natin in, sulat nyo in figures. You can pause the video if you need more time. 3 and 72, 10,000. Go. Okay, so the answer is 3 and ayan, 72, tapos thousands, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000 yan, 10,000. Next, 4 and 4 millions. Medyo mahaba ito kasi umabot tayo ng millions. Go! Okay, so 4, tapos tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, 100,000, millions. Ayan. 4 millions. Great job! Okay, so subukan natin sagutan ng lahat as assess activity ng inyong module. So ito, write in words daw. So, diretso na tayo kasi wala tayong whole number. So, diretso na tayo dito. 325, tapos tens, hundreds, thousands. So, 325,000. Next, 72 and 59, tapos 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000. So, yan. 72 and 59, 10,000. Next, 25 to, tapos 900. So, 25 and 900. So, ganun lang kasimple. And then, write the following decimal numbers in standard form. So, 9,201. So, 9,201. Okay, so this time, proceed tayo sa lesson 3, the last topic which is rounding decimal numbers to the nearest hundreds and thousands. So, ang unang activity sa inyong module ay let us try, which is the directions is encircle the letter of the correct answer. So, you have number 1, what is 40.2564 rounded to the nearest thousands? So, purely mga rounding off to. And if you have any idea how to round off, mas maganda. Siguro alam nyo na to kasi sa rounding off numbers, whole numbers kasi, which is the lesson in grade 4, magkaparehas lang naman ang concept dito. Kaya lang, ang place value lang ang ating i-observe. So, kagaya nito, thousands. So, dito tayo focus sa thousands, tens, hundreds, thousands. So, dito tayo focus sa 6. Ayan. So, kumbaga, titingnan natin ang right side niya. Ganun, ganun ang idea. So, if you answered letter A for number 1, that is correct. For number 2 naman, hundreds. So, 4, 3. Dito tayo focus sa 3. Tapos, ang kasunod niya ay 7. So, magiging 4. Ayan, letter B. And finally, number 3, thousands. So, tens, hundreds, thousands. So, 9. Ang kasunod ng 9 is 4. So, retain lang ang 9. So, 8, 7, and ayan, letter C. Okay? Well, anyway, I will be discussing now the steps in rounding off decimal numbers. Let's use the decimal number 2.95263. So, ito yung gagamitin natin. We have step number 1 is identify the digit and the place value to be rounded off. So, identify mo muna. For example, if you round off this decimal to the nearest hundreds, hundreds tayo. So, the digit in the hundreds place is 5. So, yan, tens, hundreds. So, 5. You can underline it. So, underline natin yung 5. Sorry, yan, number 5. Next, identify the first digit to the right of the underlined digit. So, first digit to the right. So, yung nasa right side niya. Ganun pa rin, kagaya ng whole number. So, ang right side niya is 2. Ayan. So, step number 3 is, kapag ang digit to the right is 0, 1, 2, or 3, or 4, ibig sabihin, mas mababa sa 5, retain lang natin, or copy lang natin tong underlined digit na 5. Pero, kapag lagpas, 5 pataas, dadagdagan natin tong 5 ng 1. Okay, round up. Kumbaga, round down and round up. So, since 2, ayan, ang 2 is less than 5, so retain natin ang number na 5. So, magiging 5 pa rin to. And step number 4 is copy all the digits to the left place of the underlined digit, then remove all the digits to the right side. So, kopyahin natin to from here, 2.9, tapos retain lang itong 5, tapos pwede nang tanggalin yan kasi wala na rin namang value yung mga zeros na yan. So, magiging 2.95. Kasi 2 ang kasunod. So, 5. 2.95. Ganon ang pag-round off ng number. Okay. Subukan natin. Halimbawa, itong 0.95163. Subukan natin sa tens. So, kung tens tayo, titingnan natin. 9. Ayan. Tapos, ang kasunod niya is 5. So, dadagdagan natin ang 9. Pag dinagdagan natin ang 9, magiging 10. Okay, tricky ito. Kasi pag naging 10 ito, sulat natin ng 0, tapos dadagdag natin ng 1 dito. Magiging 1.0 or 1. Kaya pag sinabing, it kills 99% of germs. So pag, pag 99, magiging 100. So kung pag ganyan naman, 0.9999, 99.99 kasi yan. So 99.99, yung 0.99 nun, is para na yung 1. So kumbaga, 99 plus 1 is 100% of germs daw ang mapapatay. Hundreds. So, kung hundreds naman, ang tens, hundreds, so yan ang underlined digit, tapos 1, kaya retain lang to, so magiging 0.95. Kapag thousands naman, ang thousands place ay ang 1, tapos ang kasunod niya is 6, so dagdagan natin ang 1, ang 1 na magiging 2, ayan, 0.952. Kapag 10,000 place naman, so tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, ang kasunod niya is 3. Kaya 6 retain lang. Ayan, 0.9516. Ayan. And kung kapag 100,000, tens, hundreds, thousands, 10,000, 100,000, wala nang digit to the right, so kopyahin na lang natin yung number na yan. It's understood to have 0. Kasi pag dinagdagan mo ng 0 dyan sa dulo, kaparehas lang naman ang result. So yan yung mga sagot. Okay, so we are now down to the last activity, which is the let us assess na activity ng inyong module. So, ang gagawin nyo lang is round off nyo to the nearest hundreds saka thousands. Pwede nyo i-pause ang video para subukan nyo kung tama ba yung mga sasagot nyo. Okay? Go! Okay, so, this time, in a way, I will be revealing the answer. So, 12.96, ang kasunod ng 6 is 7. So, magiging 7 to. So, 12.97. Kasunod namang 7 is 5, so magiging 8 ito. Ayan. Kasi focus tayo sa second, 1, 2, and the third na place dyan to the right of the decimal point. So dito naman, 08, ang kasunod ng 8 is 7, so magiging 9. So magiging 09 yan. Tapos ang kasunod ng 7 is 4, so retain lang 087. Ayan. Next, ang 18 naman, ang kasunod ng 4 is 3, so 44 pa rin. At ang kasunod ng 3 ay 5, magiging 4 na to, so 444. Ayan. 34, ang kasunod is 1, so 34 pa rin. At ang kasunod naman ng 1 ay 5, so magiging 2 na to, so 342. Ayan. 6, 5, so ang kasunod ng 5 is 7, so magiging 66. At ang kasunod naman ng 7 ay 5, magiging 658, kasi dadagdagan mo to ng 1. Did you get the correct answers? Okay, very good if you got the correct answers. So hanggang dito lang muna tayo, and then if you like, if you have learned something from this video, paki-like naman, saka paki-share sa iba para matuto rin sila. And please do not forget to subscribe to my channel para lagi pa kayong updated sa aking mga i-upload na mga tutorial videos. Okay, hanggang sa muli. Thank you for watching.